Hey guys, how y'all doing? We're doing. I'm. Well, she's doing well. What? She's doing well. You won? No. How old are you? That's right. Okay. Okay. Did you tell him hello? You say hi? Say hey, y'all. What are you trying to show them? Yeah. I need to talk to y'all about something. Let me tell you. Oh, you saw. Don't wipe nothing on me, girl. Hold on, yeah. Anyways, you guys, I have something important that I want to talk to you about. It's something that's weighing heavy on me. Okay. You know. When kids are, well, not all kids, but when some babies are, this child trying to fall, break her neck. You know, when some kids are young, babies, infants, you go get their ears pierced. Well, when Chunky was small, an infant, people thought she was a boy because she had really thick, curly hair. You know how boys are born with real thick, curly hair. So everybody thought she was a boy. Everybody would say, "Oh, he's so cute," or "What's his name?" and all that good stuff. So when she turned 3 months, I went to go get her ears pierced. Even though she would, you know, wear cute pink hair bows and wear pink clothes and everything, people still thought she was a boy. So I went and got her ears pierced when she turned 3 months. Okay. When you get that ear pierced, you have to get it done with. Well, this is what the woman told us. She said it had to be something real, like gold or whatever, so that their ears wouldn't mess up, you know, swell up or get infection or whatever. So that's what I did. We got her 14 karat golds in her ear, right? So, you know. So people would think and will know that she's a girl. So they said you have to keep it in for six to eight. For 6 to 8 weeks for it to. It is open. It is open, look. Yeah, they said you have to keep it in for 6 to 8 weeks before you take it out and change the earrings or whatever. They said that when you do change it, you know, make sure clean it, whatever, with the whoop. I was like, cool. So that was when she was 3 months. When she turned a year, she got some more earrings in her ear. Fine, okay. Everything went well. Y'all know she just turned two. So I was like, well, let's get some more earrings in her ear. Well, when she turned two, I didn't have any new earrings to put in there yet. I couldn't because I hadn't bought any. So the ones she already had in her ear, she couldn't keep those in there because they had started to mess up, whatever. So I took those out and I put the ones she got her ears pierced with, the infant ones, I put those back in her ear. Well, when I put them back in her ear, the skin from her ear started to grow over the earring, I guess because it was too small. I don't know. So, I didn't have any more earrings to put in her ear besides the little infant ones and besides the ones that were broke. So I put some of my earrings in her ear. Like I had some little studs. I put those in her ear. I was like, I'm gonna put this in, you know, put this in her ear until I'm able to go get her some more earrings. Well, the other day, well, I'm not even gonna say the other day. Yeah, it was the other day. Her ears, they were like kind of like they were getting bigger. So I'm like, it's because she's growing. She's getting bigger. So of course her ears are getting bigger. That's what I was thinking. But Miss D, she was like, no, though she can't wear those earrings because those are not the carrots that she got her ears pierced, so she's having an allergic reaction. So I was like, you know, how can you tell? And she was telling me because her ears were starting to swell up. She was like, that's what it looks like when they're allergic to it, whatever. So I was like, okay. So when we got home, I took the earring out of her ear. And sure enough, it was like really, really red. Like if you just with the earrings in, you just look at her ear, it like it was okay. But once I took it out, I saw that it was kind of puffy and it was red. So I took them out, whatever. And the other ear, like one ear, just was puffing red, and the other one, when I took it out, it started bleeding. Like it was crazy. As soon as I took the earring out, it started bleeding. Like a little bit of blood. I was like, man, you know, that made me feel so bad because my child was hurt, and I caused it. I caused her to hurt. So I took them out, and I put the earrings in that Miss D had bought for her. Miss D, I appreciate you. Like, I really do, because I didn't have any other earrings to put in her ear. So I'm very thankful for the earrings that you got her. So now I have to, you know, keep cleaning her ear. You know, until it heals, because it looks okay right now. You want to show me your ear? Her ear, it looks regular. It looks okay. But it's, I don't know. Like I said, when I took it out, it started bleeding. So, I don't know. Like, it's not red anymore. Like, everything seems to be normal right now. I'm going, you know, I talked to the doctor and everything, and they were like, they was like, if it's pussy or if it continues to bleed, to bring her in, but it's not doing none of that or whatever. And they told me, they asked me what happened, and I told them the earring situation and everything. And they was like, you, with her earrings, if she got her ears pierced with 14 carats, then she has to continue to get 14 carat earrings, even though it's past way past the 8 weeks or whatever of her first getting them pierced. It was like, with her still being so young, I need to keep on letting her wear 14 carats in her ear until she's a little older. So parents, I am telling you what they told me. If you get your child ears pierced, your infant, you know how you take your child to get the ears pierced, after that 8 weeks, and they tell you you can take it out and put another one in, whatever you put in there, make sure it's the same carrot that you got the ears pierced. That way it won't cause an infection, cause it to swell up, cause it to bleed or whatnot. So yeah, I'm feeling some type of way about that. To see my child bleeding, even though she wasn't crying, even though it wasn't hurting her or whatever, just to see that something that I caused her to hurt her ears, that was like really red, and like with the earrings in, you couldn't even see it. But once I took it out, I could see how red they were, and like I said, one of them had started bleeding. So we're dealing with that right now. These earrings that Miss D gave her, she's gonna keep those in for a while. I'm probably not gonna change her earrings again until she's three. Cause that was very scary, you guys. I don't know, it just it made me feel some type of way, you guys. I'm just really sad. Like, I feel like a bad mom. Like, you cause pain on your child. You cause your child to, I don't know. Another thing I want to talk to you guys about. Chunky. Her personality, she's very bossy. Like, and I know she gets that from me. And it is crazy because the other day, she's playing with a friend. It was three of them, a girl and a boy, and herself. And they was having fun. Everybody was having a good time. And the little boy, of course, him being a boy, he didn't want to play the same thing that the girls were playing, right? So he was playing with his little truck, and they were playing with the little kitchen set. And he kept telling them, hey, let's play with the truck. And they was like, no. And Two, she, this is exactly what she did. She said, no, you go sit down and play over there. That's exactly how she said to this little boy. So I look, you know, do you ever just sit back and watch your kids play with other kids and just see how they are and what they would do and everything? That's what I do sometimes. Like when she's playing with her friends, I just sit back and watch to see how she will handle different situations. So the little boy, I guess he wasn't used to people telling him what to do. So he looked and he like walked away like, this girl crazy. So, you know, he went play with some other toys. So her and the girl was still playing with the kitchen set. So the little girl wanted to sit behind the kitchen, and that's where Chunky was sitting. So Chunky had got up, and the little girl sat in Chunky's seat, and Chunky just turned around. She was like, no, you better get out of my spot. And I'm just like, you know, Chunky, don't talk to her like that. That's not nice. So the little girl started laughing or whatever. You know, they were playing. They were laughing. The little girl didn't think nothing of it. Too. Can you sit down, please? The little girl didn't think nothing of it, but, you know, I know my chat. So I told Chunky, I was like, go play. They had a little dollhouse. I said, go play at the dollhouse. So Chunky goes over there, play at the dollhouse. The little boy comes over there, and he's playing with Chunky with the dollhouse, right? Well, he takes some of the furniture in there, and he knocks them down. And they fall everywhere. Chunky got mad. She was like, oh, no, you're messy. You're messy. You better clean up. Clean up. Don't be nasty. And I was like, y'all, like, I said she sounded just like me when she said that, because I tell her that, like, when she makes a mess, I would tell her, clean it up, don't be nasty. Y'all, that's what she said to that little boy. And, you know, I was just kind of embarrassed, because the parents, they were laughing. You know, they thought it was funny. It wasn't funny to me, because I know where she got it from. And she sounded just like me when she said it. And I was like, oh, no. We are about to go. We're finna leave, because she's a child. So she can't be telling other kids what to do. She can't tell. Go put that in trash. She can't be telling other kids what to do. Even though their parents thought it was funny and everything, it was not funny to me. Because what if she would have told them what to do and they would have hit her? This would be a whole different conversation right now. So, I don't know. It's just, I have to change the way that I talk to her, because she, even with her dad, like, I used to think it was so funny that she used to tell her dad, come pick up your stuff. Like, if he took her shoes and put them on the floor, she would tell, come get this, come pick it up, nothing nasty. I used to think that was funny, but it's not funny anymore. So, I have to change the way that I talk to her, because I don't want her talking to other people like that. What else I need to talk to y'all about? Oh, let me tell you what else she did. Yeah. She was in class, right? And they have a computer in the class, whatever. It's for everybody to use. All the little kids, it's a little kid's computer. She always liked to play on there. She'd go on there, play the little games, whatever. Fine and dandy. But there's another little girl who wanted to play on it. So she has to learn that if it's not yours, you have to share it. The little girl came over, and she was like telling her what shapes and triangles and square, and Chucky was peeing after her and everything. They was playing on it. You let him out. So the little girl wanted to sit in the chair, because it's normally two chairs over there, but whatever. She wanted to sit in the chair. So, you know, she asked Chunky, she's like, can I sit? That's what the little girl said. And Chunky told her, she said, no. And I was like, Chunky, you have to share. Or whatever. Like, that's something we've been working on, her sharing. I'm like, Chunky, you have to share. So the little girl starts to sit down in Chunky's lap. Like, you know how you sit down? Like, girl, scoot over, let me sit with you. That's what the little girl was doing. Y'all, Chunky pushed her so hard. Like, the little girl went flying. Like, that was so embarrassing to me. Like, the mom was laughing, but it was like one of those little nervous laughs. Like, you know, you better go up from that little girl. She crazy. Let's go. That's the kind of laugh she was doing. So I told Chunky, I said, no, Chunky, tell her you're sorry or whatever. That's what I told Chunky. But the little girl said sorry to Chunky. She was like, I'm sorry. I was like, no, baby, you're okay. It's her. I was like, Chunky, tell her you're sorry. So Chunky was like, sorry. But the way she said it, I knew she wasn't sorry. And you know that song, that Beyonce song, Sorry, I Ain't Sorry? Yeah. that is my jam. Like, I love Beyonce. That's my jam. And we listen to a lot of Beyonce. Man, Chuck and I, we are the Beehive fans for real. But the thing is, Chunky. Even when she was in my belly, we listened to Beyonce a lot. This little girl, they playing again. Chunky pushes her down again. Like, I don't mean no like regular push. I mean like push. Like, I'm pushing your soul out of you. She pushed the little girl again. I said, Chunky, stop. I was like, tell her you're sorry. Yeah, I kid you not. This is what Chunky said. I ain't sorry. Y'all, when she said that, it's like I was so embarrassed. Like, and then the librarians and everybody that was up in there, they started laughing. They thought it was funny. And I was like, no, it's not funny. They was like, oh, we see she a little Beyonce fan. I was like, yeah. But y'all, I was so embarrassed. I was like, why my child so mean? And I was like, am I mean? Is that why she's like that? Because I'm like that? Yeah, it has me feeling some type of way. I'm all in my feelings right now. Yeah, I'm all in my feelings. I don't know. We had to give him a leave because I didn't know what she would do next. Like, she already pushing. She already telling people she ain't sorry. I didn't know what was gonna happen next, and I didn't want to stick around because what if that child's mom was to get mad at Chunky for pushing her? Because if the tables were turned, like if that little girl would have pushed Chunky that hard, I would have felt some type of way. I wouldn't have said nothing because they're kids. I would be like, Chunky, let's go, let's move, whatever.
I love basketball.
Popsicle? Did you put it in the trash?
Basketball.
You ate it all?
Basketball.
I don't know, you guys.
Basketball.
Look, you're not finna get another popsicle. You already had one. Be careful. I just. Yeah. I don't know. What do y'all think? Dude, what should I do? Because I can't whoop her because whoopers don't faze her. Like, whenever I tried that, she just hit me back. And then I'd be hurt. So, whooping someone's face, her timeout does not work for her. Like, I don't know. You know what works for her is whenever she's doing something bad, I start, crying. I'm like, oh my goodness. And she's like, what's wrong? I'm like, you hurt my feelings because you're so bad. Then she's like, oh, I'm sorry, mommy. And, she's still acting good. But it's like, for how long would that work? That's the question.
Mama?
Yeah. Anyways, thank you guys for listening to me just rant and talk. I just need someone to talk to because I'm feeling some type of way. I'll catch you guys later.